Holy sh! My legitimate reaction to finding out that this cube is only $9. Today, we're taking a look at the RS3M 2020 Edition Speedcube. But don't let its name fool you. Unlike 2020, this Speedcube is actually quite good. This cube is an updated release of the MF3 RS3M. These two cubes are very similar, but the first thing you'll notice is the difference in their colors. I feel like this cube looks better and more vibrant because of how solid the colors are. While on the older cube, it's a bit more translucent and doesn't look quite as good in some areas. I really like the red-orange and the white-yellow contrast. For the green-blue, I feel like the darker green doesn't look quite as nice, but for my recognition on solving, I like this a lot better. The turning of this cube is really smooth and fast, but that also depends on a little bit of the settings, which I'll talk about later. It comes with magnets to help align your turns and stabilize the cube. The magnet strength is quite moderate, and for not being able to change it, I think that this is pretty good. One of my main criticisms of the original RS3 was that the magnet strength was too weak for just how fast and loose this cube felt. For the magnets in this cube, ideally they could be a bit stronger, but I don't think you would really dislike the magnet strength in this cube as it's not like too far in either direction. The corner cutting is quite good, and these are with the screw settings that are just out of the box. The regular corner cutting, once you get to 45 degrees, starts to take a lot more effort, but before that is pretty okay. And with reverse corner cutting, it's actually quite effortless. So here's the box for this cube, and if you open it, it actually comes with both the cube and an accessory box. Inside here, what we have is a screwdriver and some extra stuff below it. This is the adjustment tool for the spring compression system, and this is just another replacement piece if you happen to lose one of them. So if you pop out the center cap, then what you can see is a blue circle device here, and this is what you use to adjust the springs. Right now it's on the lowest setting as there's no room between the teeth of the blue and the white. But if you use this tool and put the notches on the holes there and then start to turn counterclockwise, you can start to move the teeth upwards all the way to the top right here, so right before it would go over the edge. The higher it is, the stronger the springs are. So right now the white layer would not be any tighter because that's controlled by the screw, but it would feel a lot slower and have more friction compared to the other side. So you can set this on one of many settings. I believe it's around 8 possible settings for how tight you want the springs to be. Of course, you'd want these equal on all sides, and that can control how flexible the cube feels and how fast it is. If you have it on the lower spring compression, your cube will be faster and more flexible, but of course that also comes with lower control. And if you put it on the higher spring compression, the opposite is true. What I really like about this system is you actually don't have to use the tool, so you don't have to bring something around with you if you ever want to change this. You can actually just turn it with your fingernails. So just like that. Now there's that in the screw, but you probably shouldn't need to touch the screw as the setting that comes out of the box is already pretty good. One very small issue I had with this cube is it didn't come lubed out of the box. Now, generally factory lube, if not a premium service, is not going to be that great anyway, but it does prevent dust buildup that can really, really start to mess up the cube. Not permanently, but having a dusty cube is going to make it really bad, and you have to clean it out and re-lube it at some point. So especially for newer cubers, I think it's good when it comes with a little bit of lube inside so the cube doesn't start to perform worse very quickly. What I did was just put a little bit of Weight 3 and also 4 drops of Martian lube, and then it was great. I tried doing solves on some of the spring compressions, so the lowest spring compression, the highest, and also right in the middle. When I put it on the lowest, the cube was still good, but definitely not my style, where it was more loose and unstable, very, very fast, and I feel like the magnet strength was not really strong enough for me to like it on the setting. On this setting, it reminds me a lot of the original RS3. On the strongest setting, it actually reminds me a lot of a Valk. You need to turn a lot more accurately as the cube slows down, and the magnet strength is not too strong. I really like this cube on the middle setting, as I feel like it complements the magnet strength quite well. On this setting, it's still quite fast, sometimes hard to control, but I don't feel like slowing it down really plays to its strengths. I was actually able to get some pretty good times with this cube, and I would rank this now probably either second or third after the Gan XS. The other cube that's second or third would be the Valk Elite. And if you look at their prices, that's crazy. So if you're really unsure about what cube to get, I highly recommend the RS3M 2020 as it is a very low commitment and there's a simple, non-overwhelming customization system that I think is quite effective. I mostly only have good things to say about this cube, but there is just like one thing that's not super working for me. It's that because the cube is super fast and smooth and also quite light, the turns that I'm doing or like the feeling that I get midway through turns doesn't feel as impactful. I'm not sure if that's the right word. It's just, this is a really weird thing to try and describe. But what I get on the GAN XS, which is my current main, it's, I guess, a more tactile feel. Like, it feels like I am more in control. I mean, if it's such a small difference that I'm having a tough time describing exactly what it is, that goes to show how small of a difference it is. And when it comes to a difference this small, maybe it's worth saving $50. So I still like the GAN XS more, but just by a little bit. And being completely honest, if I were a new SpeakCuber today, I would get the RS3M 2020. Actually, I do have one more issue with it. We used to make fun of these old cubes and call them the license plate because it's just a string of letters and numbers. So I'm glad they took off the MF3, but then they added 2020 at the end of it. So the naming of this cube was a bit of a disaster, but what do you expect? As always, I want to thank SpeakCube Shop for sending me this cube to review, and if you want to check it out, there is a link in the description, and remember to use the discount code JBERM. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all next time.